Hello friends, this is Durga again from IT Varsity, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. As part of this video, I will be talking about MySQL database. And you might be wondering why I'm talking about a relational database such as MySQL in big data related stuff. So the purpose of MySQL is to simulate the relational database to ingest data into Hadoop or big data clusters. If you think about it, none of the mission critical applications will not be deployed on top of HDFS and MapReduce are Spark based solutions. Typically, mission critical applications are deployed on top of databases like Oracle, MySQL, Postgres, Informix, etc. And some of them will be on NoSQL also, but none of them will be on MapReduce based solutions or Spark based solutions. They are primarily for micro batches or macro batches for offline data processing. Typically, the big data solutions, especially the Spark and Hadoop MapReduce oriented applications, will not be customer facing. That being said, we need to identify the sources and we need to copy data into the big data systems to process data offline using MapReduce based solutions such as Hadoop, MapReduce, and Spark. So, one of the sources will be relational database, and I'm talking about MySQL in the context of that, just to provide you a simulated environment where you can perform the data ingestion by connecting to source databases into big data clusters using technologies like Scoop, Spark, JDBC, etc. So in our lab, we provide MySQL server, and in future we will be providing other databases also to practice, and that will be taken care in future. So let me go ahead and try to show you how you can connect to the MySQL and how you can access the information in the MySQL. So for that, to access MySQL, you need to have the subscription to the Big Data Labs, which is created by IT Varsity. So on this page, you can see this Enroll Now, or you can also click on this to subscribe to the lab. Once you subscribe to the lab by making the payment, you can connect either by using terminal or console. For example, let me log in this case. So if you already have access, you will get the credentials here itself. My Wi-Fi seems to be a little bit slow. So you can click on this open console and you can use the credentials. So here you can copy with this thing, paste, make sure you use Shift Insert. If you are using Windows, not Control V. If you use Control V, it can cause some issues. Means it will not be pasted. And then copy password. If it is Mac, just use Command V and hit enter. I think I pasted twice, that's why it failed. Let me copy the username and then the password. Now it will log in. And now you can say MySQL hyphen U retail underscore DBA. You can copy paste. From here. Okay, so here you are connecting to the gateway node. Okay, you are on the gateway node. If you run hostname hyphen -s, you will see the actual name of the host. But if you paste that MySQL command, it is actually connecting to a different host called nn01.itvarsity.com, and this is the syntax: MySQL hyphen -u username hyphen H stands for host. You have to give the host name or IP address on which MySQL database is running and hyphen P to prompt for the password. And the password is ITVarsity, and now you are in the MySQL. And then you can run show databases command to list the databases. There are three databases. Retail underscore DB is a read-only database. This user called retail underscore DBA have only read-only permissions on retail underscore DB. So if you just want to read data from that database, you can use this one. But for other purposes, you can use retail underscore export and retail underscore import. Okay. So in this case, I am trying to get on to retail DB database. Show tables to list the tables, and then select style from departments to preview the data. So make sure you run these commands and get used to MySQL, and it will help you to troubleshoot issues later. Okay, so this is brief overview about MySQL. We'll be using this MySQL database in Scoop, Spark, JDBC, etc. in the latter point in time, and we will review these things again at that time. This is just a brief overview about each of the components which are relevant for developers to learn big data on the lab, and we will take it further as and when it is required. That being said, thank you very much. Bye.